Here we go with the Tri-State Audi Nick's post-game show. Nick Vucevic of the Bulls out because of COVID-19. Bulls don't have a big man, so Julius Randle goes for 34, but the Bulls go 5 of 8 from downtown in the fourth. And DeMar DeRozan goes for 31. Bulls as a team in the fourth quarter scored 37 points and beat the Knicks. Final score tonight from Chicago, 109 to 103, as we present the Tri-State Audi Knicks postgame show. Great to have you with us from our Delta MSG studios, Bill Pito, Alan Hahn, and Wally Szczerbiak. You know, we got the stat sheet right here. Pretty even, Wally. Bottom line, with the game on the line, it was easier for the Bulls than it was for the Knicks on the offensive end.
And that's traditionally how it is in the NBA. When you have a guard that's handling the ball out front, he can orchestrate, make decisions. He's a lot more comfortable when the defense tightens up in the fourth quarter, whereas Julius Randle was phenomenal through three quarters. I mean, he was outstanding. The Bulls don't have a guy on their roster without Vucevic and Patrick Williams in the lineup who can guard Julius Randle. And I think the Knicks did a great job of exploiting that, going to Julius Randle. But at the same time, in the fourth quarter, sometimes you need the ball in a guard's hands where he can see what's going on, kind of like a quarterback overseeing the play, making the right read, making the right decision. Julius Randle, his first thought is score. He did his job tonight. He scored. But when you put him in a position to have to sometimes play make, when he's trying to get to an open spot to make a shot, that's where he struggled a little bit with some of the passes that he threw. But overall, the effort was there from Julius Randle and the whole entire Knicks team. It just came down to the Bulls have two of the elite scorers in the NBA that know how to close, and they close this game.
Yeah, what Julius Randle needed was a supporting cast player, was somebody else to support what he was doing. And Kemba Walker tried to do it in the third quarter. In fact, that helped the Knicks get out to a 6-point lead because Kemba was being that second guy that can get you some buckets. But if you look at the starting lineup, Randle got 34 points on 13 of 19. The rest of the starters were 9 of 32. So, you know, somebody else has got to do something offensively for him, for his offense to be effective, and for him to not have to carry as much weight as he did. Defensively, the Knicks, all of the check marks that Tom Thibodeau looks at, you know, defensive field goal percentage, well, you held the Bulls to 42%. You know, they had to earn, they had to work for their points. Late in the game, of course, they made some shots that opened this thing up to a bigger lead than this was a tight game. 13 turnovers kept under control after a bad first half. Three-point issues for this team also remain something that also needs to be addressed, as they are not making the three-point shot. But the bottom line is the offense is still something that is struggling, but at least the effort defensively is there, and that's what made this to be a good game for the Knicks.
Randle at 34 points. No other Knick had more than 13, and that was guys off the bench.
Right.
Quickly had 12. Brooks had 13. Barrett, 9 points, but did tie his career high with 15 rebounds. Take us through the fourth quarter. I mean, that was where the game was won. Final 6 minutes.
Well, it was also the first 6 minutes of the fourth quarter when the Chicago hit 5 out of 6 threes.
Right, right.
Bang, 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 bang to get the lead back when the Knicks had a 4-point lead in the fourth quarter and at the end of the third quarter. Those corner threes have just been killing the Knicks all year long. Lonzo Ball hits that huge three from the corner. Alec Burks, we know he'll do it when needed, and he knocks down that three, which cut the lead to only 2. And then Barrett with the bucket and the foul, and that's a 2-point game still for the Bulls. But look at the way DeMar DeRozan just gets the switch that he wants. I mean, Randle's a versatile defender, but it's a lot to ask Randle, your four-man, to guard a 26-point-per-game score in the NBA. Here again, the switch.
High release. Watch the high release.
Yeah, the high release,
oh, that's the
pass.
Kick out here. Okay, right.
And then, look, you're passing it to another top-five scorer in the NBA who knows how to put the ball in the basket in the fourth quarter with an advantage. He's a great athlete. He can attack and get to the basket. Again, Knicks' effort was phenomenal. I just think they need to continue to work. And you said it best, the defense was there. Mm-hmm. And that's the identity of this team. That's why I thought the Knicks were going to win this game. I thought they were going to outgrind the Bulls in their house in this game. But give the Bulls a lot of credit. This is one of the better teams in the East. They're showing that they've completely turned things around. The offseason acquisitions that they made, DeMar DeRozan is going to be one of the tops because that guy can flat out play, and he's been doing it for years.
Playing like an MVP. And those corner threes were big. Kobe White came in and knocked down some threes off the bench, but they were 5 of 6 from the corner three in that fourth quarter.
Now, you got Ball, DeRozan, and LaVine out there with the game on the line. That's a lot of playmaking, a lot of mobility and versatility.
Yes.
And
that's you need in the fourth quarter.
Whereas the Knicks, it's just every time.
Well, the Knicks have Rose, Burks, and Randle. You know, and then they have Quickly spacing the floor. They have Toppin hitting the offensive board. So they have three guys that can orchestrate the
offense. It just was a bad shooting night for them. I mean, Quickly's totally. 1-for-8 from three. He had some great looks from three, a couple of them that you felt like, I need it. And it just wasn't a night that he was knocking them down. You know, look, you're the Bulls, you're at home. You already lost to the Knicks at home once before. You got to win this game. Like, for the Bulls, you got to win this game. The Knicks did not play well offensively, but they grinded on the road to be in the game late. But home team wins this game when they're a good team. You know,
the better shooting team wins this game. Well, that's why the Bulls won this game. Late. The team that makes the shots late.
Yeah.
And just like the Knicks made the shots against Houston the other day late. Alec Burks went bonkers in the fourth quarter and was on fire. The Bulls did the same thing. Kobe White was money in the bank from that corner three, and so was Lonzo in the fourth quarter.
And guys, Randall, you mentioned Wally, 34 points, but perhaps most impressively, Alan, 13 of 19 from the floor.
Yeah, very efficient game for Julius Randle. And one, again, that he had to be the scorer. He'd been trying to be a playmaker for a while here to get other people involved. But this was a game, as Wally mentioned, look at the matchup. Alex Caruso, he's given up size, he's given up weight, and he kept taking him into that mid-post, and he was getting the shots off. This looked a lot more like the Julius Randle from last season, when he was getting those one-on-ones where he'd get guys in the mid-post and he would score. And he can knock down at three. And what was good is that he didn't take a lot. He only took two threes. He made the one. But this was the Julius Randle we remember last year. Good footwork, good post work. Look at this. This is all in the Bernard King office.
Such a big size advantage.
Right. And they don't have size. They were playing small ball. Again, look at this right here. Just up fakes and just one-on-one play. They weren't sending a lot of doubles. When they did, he was passing out of it willingly. Look at this shot with one hand, Wally. That takes some strength as well. But this was a little bit of, we want to call it a little vintage, Julius Randle.
And it was also manipulated by Coach Thibodeau. He knew he was a little thin at the front line position, so he knew he had to go small and he had to trust that small ball lineup. And he knew his queen on the chessboard was Julius Randle, and he came through. And this is something that I think the coaching staff and Tom Thibodeau can learn from. You have to help Julius Randle because obviously he's the number one guy up on the board every single game that teams are trying to stop. Yeah. So you got to try to manipulate matchups, manipulate lineups, put guys around him that are going to give him a little bit of an advantage in a one-on-one situation. Not have him just draped on with two guys with a lot of length that he can't get to his spot and then see the rim to knock down his shots. Tonight, the Knicks trusted the small lineup. It worked for a while, and they're going to have to learn from that and trust it at times to help Julius Randle just get a little bit more into the rhythm and get some easier shots.
Nerlens Noel started because Mitchell Robinson's in concussion protocol. Taj Gibson out with a bad groin. Noel had some foul trouble. So we, a lot of times with Obi not in there, saw Randle in four wings.
Yeah.
I don't know that we've seen that under Tom Thibodeau with Randle in four wings. But as you mentioned, at times it was very effective tonight.